today we are going to start disassembling the front door of the trailer so that we can reskin it. And we'll probably have to do a little bit of rebuilding. These doors look terribly difficult to work on when you first take a look at it, but in reality they're fairly simple. So the first thing we're going to do is remove the hardware. Very difficult there, nothing difficult about that. I'm going to replace this hardware because it goes the wrong way. This is for a left-hand door, and I have a right-hand door. So I just had this lying around. It's worked so far for a while for just keeping the door closed. So, anyway, pull this putty tape off of here for now, put new stuff on later, get around to that. Alright. Now, most of these older doors, they're all built the same. All the 50s models are pretty much the same. I'm going to take you around and show you some details. On the ends, you'll notice that the aluminum is folded over. You won't need to unfold this in too many of the cases. There's a little bit of metal you'll have to unfold. But in most cases, there's not that much you have to really unfold. And you don't really want to, because the more times you bend this aluminum, the easier it is to break on a corner. They're all held in with these twisty tack nails. These are nails with round heads, and they have twisted shanks. You've seen them. They pound in and they sort of twist like a screw. We need to get all those out first. And as you remove the pieces, each piece, before you remove it, write on it what piece it is, either the bottom, the top, or the left side, or the right side. You can also mark these as the open side and the jam side, whatever, just so you know which side is which and how it goes back. So this is the hinge side, actually, so you might want to just mark this as the hinge side as you take it off. This is the top. I'll be marking that as top, and then you don't even have to mark that one because it's the closing side or the handle side. So as long as you have the hinge side marked, then you know what's what. You also, just for reference, may want to mark the top of the hinge side and the top of the closing side. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to use one of these little tiny cat's paws. This is a nice little tool I showed you when we were taking the skin off the trailer. This was able to get under there and get those little nails out. Well, this is what we're going to use to get all these twisty nails out. And it takes a while. It takes a while, so hope you got lots of patience. Tabby, do you have lots of patience? Are you a patient doggy? Good, because it's going to take a while. Hey! Look at me! Say hello to everybody. Huh? Say hello. So I believe I'll start with the closing side. And stick the cat's paw under the metal. Bend that out just a little bit just to get the nail started. It's outward motion. Like I say, you have to be careful. This could take a while. See, here I am being careful. Damn it.
right off the bat we got a problem. Like I say, this is going to take a while. Now, if everything's not too rotten, once you get the head exposed a little bit, you'll have to grab it with these pincher pliers, which you saw these used in the removal of the skin also. You'll have to actually untwist them, because they're almost like a screw. There, that's the last of the side nails. And I'm just going to get this one out. Here. And this is just like taking the skin off. This is a long, tedious process getting these screws or the nails out of here. One to go. There. Now there's also one nail in each corner on the front. It'll have to be removed. And you want to be careful removing those because you're dealing with the exterior look of the thing. So I'm going to have to get another cat's paw now because I just broke this one. So I'll be back after I go to the store and get another one. Oh, I got my new cat's paw. It's actually called a tack lifter. You can see it there. Tack lifter. It's just a little cat's paw. A little tiny one. This one looks like it's a little bit better made. It was $3.50 at the local Ace Hardware. So, we want to be really careful here. Usually when I say that, I end up ruining things, but you really do want to be careful here. Try and get these out without hurting the aluminum. I don't know if this is going to work that well. It's kind of wide. It's a little wider than the other one was. I'm not sure. Doesn't seem to want to get in there and grab the pin. I'm getting it. Yeah, that's got it. Okay. There, we have another one in each corner that we'll take out. Now in some cases you might not be able to get the two separated, like in this case here. I can't get this under here, so what I'm going to do is just lift it up a little bit from the skin in between there like that. Take this little hacksaw and cut through it. There, actually, that loosened it up. Now I can get it out. You never know what's going to happen. Oops, okay. Putting that back in place.